Hey everyone, a little over a year ago today, All City Canvas, in conjunction with Herman Miller's philanthropic division, Herman Miller Cares, commissioned one of street art's legends and masters of geometric beauty, Augustine Kofie, who created this mind-blowing piece behind me in Mexico City. Now, as an homage to our dear friend, we invite you to check out our second short story ever produced, because to remember is to live. Enjoy.
You can understand why all y'all ancestors worship the sun. For everybody, all of our ancestors worship the sun. How could that not be a god?
We both know this empty sky.
My name is Augustine Kofie, born and raised, bred in the city of Los Angeles. Some circles know me as a graffiti writer, some circles know me as a muralist, and some circles I'm known as a fine artist. I like to think I'm a mixed media artist. I work in multiple mediums. I'm taking a little note of it. It always seems like more of just a little memory of where I am. In a way, this is me experiencing it. I'm not trying to draw it perfectly. If I was, I'd be spending more time here, but to me, this is just like a note, seeing things a little differently.
There's foundation to what I'm doing. I didn't come out the blue doing geometry. My school was absorb and take in everything that you like. Look at it, but find a way to flip it even harder if you can. Change it, transcend it, evolve it. That's how I am. I'll take something and I'll try to deconstruct it and rebuild it.
Symmetry, you guys are about symmetry, I swear. It's everything symmetrical. That's not easy to do either. Damn, that headpiece. It's like an eye. Good Lord.
My inspiration, in terms of like from different artists, it runs the gamut. It's the same as with music. I like all forms of music and design. You know, in terms of classic American, New York style, Ramel Z, Gandhi White, Phase 2, Futura, obviously, and of course, just for someone who was thinking outside the box early on and did his own thing, that's so admirable and respected. Even folks outside of the graffiti realm, I always tended to gravitate toward imagery and design that I admired, like Lebeus Woods, Sid Mead, Lee Bontecue, female sculptor and painter. Siqueiros, too, the first time I really got to see his work in person. Books do not give it justice. Seeing that work and the fact that he experimented and he used tools in his pieces, and it was very politically based, something that I normally cannot connect with. My work does not have a politically driven foundation. I hate to even think that my work is decorative in essence. I hate to think that. I do understand it when you deal with geometrics and colors and forms and non-figurative elements, but his work is intense.
There's a uniformness, I think, with that, when they're all together like that, and compiled and compressed. Every bit is covered. I'm sorry, but I think that's spray paint. The spray paint was designed in the 50s. If it's the 60s, it's definitely plausible. I like that it usually gets a negative connotation because it's used for vandalism, but it is actually as a tool. It's an implement. It's a pigment. It's just applied using a finger and pressure. And that's red spray paint over the black and brush strokes over it. There's tape, there's a line of tape. When you see a really rigid line inside.
Yeah, I love that you use tape too.
The painting I do now still involves the tools I learned when I was a kid. My appreciation of the spray can as a medium, making paintings and murals out of stuff you get at the hardware store. I was lucky enough to have a mother who was an artist who studied art at the university. She was really good at art in school, and she went to UCLA on the strength of that. But then having a child, and then having a child with a father who was not super supportive financially, she kind of had to go back to the basics and kind of knew that she wouldn't be able to do art for a living. But creativity was nurtured in my youth, and to have art supplies around was not a thing. It was normal for me. My mom and I moved to this neighborhood called Palms, which is West Los Angeles, and I was pissed. I didn't want to move. I had no say in the matter. And for an introvert kind of kid, I didn't want to do that. But I like to explore. I found some tracks, I followed them, and then boom. Where these old railway tracks met with the 10 freeway, there's basically like this old tunnel. These cement walls was a yard called the Motor Yard. I lived 6 blocks away from this thing. And it was the late 80s, early 90s. In this place, it was the first graffiti art I've ever like stepped into. And I was just mesmerized, looking at all the color, trying to translate the lettering and the hand styles and then the pieces. And then me, not knowing anything about those, I gravitated towards the caricature pieces on the wall. So I paid attention to that. But then I like, there's these piles of spray cans on the floor. And it's like, really, all this is done with a spray can? I've done this many a times, but it's always gonna be intimidating and daunting, especially in a place that you're not comfortable with. You're out of your comfort zone, you're here. No matter how cool everybody is, the way I am, it's like, I'm still be like, all right.
See how that breaks up? It looks like a lighter gray. It's basically enamel water. Oil and water don't mix.
I've always had a spray bottle when I'm doing pieces because I like to dilute the water-based paint, the acrylic and the latex. Obviously, you're not gonna be able to see this from down there, but from a distance, the gradation on this is beautiful. It's like a pixelation. That is like some of the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. You get a different gradation, and it just looks sexy. I mean, I can look around now. We're on the rooftop of the hub. I love this. The wiring, the buildings, the bump together, the structure and the form. Like, I love that. You don't get to see things like this in my city very often. When I travel, I see this. I feel bits of like Paris, I feel bits of Japan. But then again, nothing is comparable to this place. Every wall is different. There's some stuff that I question, is it too much? Is there too many things going on? Everyone seems to like it. It was a rough one to start. But ultimately, after we get the first colors up there and the paint I was using was like sitting perfectly, then I was like, oh, okay, now I feel better. It's like going into a home that you're gonna move into and it's just tore up. You gotta clean it up, and then you really get to see it. So after we got color on, I was like, oh, okay, I feel better. We're nearing the end. Now when I get a wall, I'm usually like asked to paint a wall or I get invited. Or if it's a wall that I've had already. For me, it was me finding a way to still be active on the street, but do something different and unique. And I wasn't doing my name, I was just doing these shapes. Same thing, it has always been shapes. It's always been some like deconstruction of the letter forms I learned throughout the 90s and into the 2000s. So I like what I do. I'm very happy with what I do. Sometimes I'm very surprised that I'm able to do this and I've stuck to it. You know, I'm pleased with what I do. I don't go out saying that to everyone. I mean, there has to be, you have to have some belief and trust in yourself. And you know, sometimes when someone asks that question, they should say themselves if they're an art, because you should like what you do. If I didn't like it, I wouldn't be doing it. I'd be trying to figure out something else that works for me. But I like what I do.